All right, let's sit comfortably, easily in cross-legged position. With a gentle smile on your face. Relax with your spine straight. Navel tucked in, shoulders relaxed away from the ear. Chin parallel to the floor. Take a deep breath in. And let it go. Another breath in. And exhale completely. Let's chant Om 3 times. Take a breath in for Om. Bring your awareness within. Feel the vibrations of sound Om. Let's do some deep breaths, yogic breaths. Take a deep breath in. Expand your belly. Keep breathing in. Expand your chest. Breathe into your throat. Little bit more. Hold it and slowly breathe out, dropping your chest, pulling your navel in. Another deep breath in. Expand your belly from all directions. Breathe into your lungs. Feel the rise in your chest. Breathing in, feel the collarbones rising up. And slowly breathe out. Relaxing your chest, pulling your navel in. Exhale completely. Let's do 2 more rounds at your own pace. And relax, finishing this round. So I think everybody should know Kapalbhati. So I will not give so many instructions. We'll just start together. You can put your right hand on your navel if you want, and you can put your left hand in Chin Mudra. Take a deep breath in and let it go. Breathe in for Kapalbhati. Out, in, out. In, out, and continue. Bring your awareness in between of the eyebrows. Feel Feel the sensations in your body, in your mind. Let's do the second round. Take a deep breath in and let it go. Breathe in for Kapalbhati. Out, in, out, in, out, in, out. In, out, and continue. And relax. When you exhale in Kapalbhati, do forceful exhalation and contract your belly. Pull your navel in all the way to spine. And then after a breath, just release it. And inhalation is passive. Let's do the third and final round. Take a deep breath in. And exhale. Breathe in for Kapalbhati. Up. In, out, in, out, in, out, and continue. And relax. Kapal means skull, Bhati is shining. So it brings glow to your skull. Means it increases the intellect, focus, and at the same time it increases your metabolism. It's very good for your abdomen. But people who have some abdominal surgery, hernia, they should do it gently. Now we'll do one more pranayam today called Agni Sara. You can open your eyes and sit like this, like bring one leg in front of the other. Have a little bit wider sitting posture. Keep your hands on your knees, palms facing down. So just observe one time for me and then we'll together. We'll breathe in, bring your head back. We breathe out with open mouth and bend forward. And bring our body up, hold our breath. We do chin to the chest, apply the throat lock, and we are not breathing here. And then elbow straight and move our belly in and out. As many times as you can do that. And then when you cannot hold your breath, simply relax your head and breathe in. Okay. So the key point here is you push your palms onto your knees so that your elbow is straight and you apply throat lock and you are holding your breath. Got it? Okay, let's do it together. Take a deep breath in and bring your head back. Breathe out, bend forward, open mouth, exhale. Completely breathe out. Bring your body up, chin to the chest. Push your palms onto the knees, elbow straight, and move your belly in and out. And relax. Agni Sara is a very good pranayam to increase your digestive fire. Let's do the second round. Take a deep breath in. Bring your head back. Breathe out, bend forward. Bring your head up, Apply chin to the chest, hold your breath, and move your belly in and out. Elbow straight, push your palms onto the knees. Very nice. Whenever you're done, come up. So, Srikant, don't move your upper body, just the belly. I observe you, you're doing this. So, your upper body is not moving, just the belly. Just try that, okay? Let's do the third and final round, keeping your eyes closed. Take a deep breath in, move your head back, breathe out. Hold your breath. Relax your hands after finishing the round. Palms facing up, keeping your eyes closed. Now, let's cross, change the cross of your legs. Bring the other leg forward. And let's do pendulum rotation. Move your body left and right. And see if you can bring your elbows down. Now bring your hand down and move the opposite hand on the above the ear. Look up towards the ceiling. Open your chest. You should not be like this. Open your chest. All the yoga postures, most of it, we want to open our chest so that our breathing capacity is more. And alternate. And gently come to the center. Let's do some neck rotation. Breathe in, bring your head back. Breathing out, chin to the chest. And let's rotate our neck from right to left. Slow and gentle. Breathing in half circle and breathing out other half. And let's reverse, breathing in to left and up, breathing out right and down. Finishing this round, come to the center. Now again, push your palms onto the knees. We will do the full body rotation. Take a breath in, bring your head back. Breathing out, bend forward, and let's rotate your whole upper body from right, back, left, and down. Make sure you are breathing in half circle and breathing out other half. People who know Ujjayi breath, they can use Ujjayi breath. And make sure you're not just rotating your neck, you're rotating the whole body, upper body. Slow and gentle. Finishing this round, let's reverse direction. Breathing in to left and up. Breathing out right and down. Finishing this round, let's come up. Now bring your hands parallel to the floor and let's twist left and right. Now let's bring our both of the hands towards the right side to the sitting spinal twist. Left hand onto your right knee, right hand behind the back and look over your right shoulder. Let's change to the left side. And let's keep changing with the breath. And let's come to the tabletop. We'll do more spinal warm up. Bring your hands underneath your shoulder, knees underneath your hips. Breathe out, bring your chin to the chest, round your upper back. Breathing in, push your navel to the floor, look up. Arch your lower back. Breathe out, chin to the chest. Breathe in, look up. Breathe out, chin to the chest. Breathe in, look up, breathe out, chin to the chest. Finishing this round, come to the neutral position, tuck your feet in, just raise your knees a little bit high, pull your navel in, look forward on the floor. Now, bring your head to the floor, chest to your thighs. Your heels are away from the floor. And then gently straighten your knees, keeping the position, the posture, the back straight. When you do this way, your back is straight. So always try to do this way. Once you get the alignment, you go into the downward dog straight. Now you can walk your dog, bend one knee and straighten the other and alternate. Gently walk your feet towards your hands, keeping the palms on the floor. Bring your chest to your thighs. Now gently see if you can straighten your knees a little bit and come to the forward fold. Drop your head towards the knees. Now hold your elbows together and swing your body up and down, left and right. Pull your navel in. Feel the stretch behind the knees, behind the calves. And now gently slide your hands on your legs and slowly and gently come up. Bring your head up in the last. Keep your eyes closed. Come to the center of your mat. Gently open your eyes. Now bring your hands towards the ceiling, palms facing up, and stretch your hands up. Now come on to your tippy toes and walk on your toes, keeping the length in your spine. Walk forward, walk backward. And then come to the center. Keeping the length in your spine, just bring the heels down to the floor. Keep your legs straight, stretch, spine elongated. Breathe in, now turn your whole body towards your right side and look towards the back. It's very good asana for reducing your fat on the sides and for your back. Breathing in, come to the center, stretch up again. So Vrinda, clasp your fingers together. Everybody, I think you cannot see my hands. So clasp your fingers, palms facing up, so that you feel stretch in your hands. Stretch it up. Now turn your body towards the left side. And look back. Come to the center, stretch it a bit again, and now bend towards your right side. Keeping your biceps close to the ear, look forward. Open your chest. You're not bending forward or backward. Gently come up. Bend towards the left side now. Keep breathing. And gently come up. Bring your hands forward. Stretch it outward. Relax your palms and let's rotate our palms, rotate our wrist. Slow and gentle, and see if you can make 360 degree rotation. Bring it on the side and let's rotate here. Feel the squeeze and expansion in your shoulder blades. And bring it on the back, clasp your fingers, push your shoulder, squeeze your shoulder blades and down. Breathe in, head up, little bit back bend. Breathing out, bend forward, bring your hands towards the ceiling. Bring your head towards the knees, pull your navel in. And stay here, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Gently come up. And relax your hands. Relax your shoulders. We'll do one round of Surya Namaskar so that we warm up the whole body. Then I will go over different postures alignments. Come to the top of your mat. Bring your hands in prayer position. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in, bring your hands up, back bend. Breathing out, bring your hands forward and down, forward fold. Bring your right leg back, right knee on the mat, and look up. Push your hips forward. Bring your left leg back, come to the plank position. So, Vinita, push your legs little back, hips up, and slide your body little forward. Yes. Now bring your knees, chest, chin to the ground, hips away from the floor. Ashtang Namaskar. Slide your body forward, come to the cobra. Your navel is touching the floor, your shoulders away from the ear, and look up. Tuck your feet, come to the downward facing dog. Bring your right leg forward. So, I can't see many people, I can see only Vinita. Vinita, move your leg with the support of your right hand forward so that your knee is perpendicular to your ankle. And move the left leg back and left knee on the mat. Yes. And push your hips forward and look up. Tuck your feet. Bring your left leg forward. And forward fold. Breathing in. Bring your hands up. Push your hips forward. Back bend. Look up. Breathing out. Relax your hands. So I'll show you the posture, and just because I can't see many people there, your mat is like this. So when we go to downward facing dog and we bring our legs like this, so some people's legs is like this. You see my, okay, let me show this direction. My knee is like crossing my toes. So if you cannot move your leg like this, move, put your hand behind the calf and push the leg forward. So now you see my leg is perpendicular. So this is the right alignment. Otherwise, you may have some knee pain. It is not good for the knee joint. Okay? So always be aware of that. Everybody got it? Okay. And the other point is you can move your this leg little back. That will also help. Okay? Let's do the other side. Take a deep breath in, hands in prayer position, and breathe out. Breathe in, bring your hands up, push your hips forward, and look up. Breathing out, bend from your hips, go to the forward fold. Breathe in, left leg as back as you can. Knee on the floor, right knee perpendicular to your ankle. Push your hips forward and look up. Breathe in, right leg back, left knee up, and come to the table plank position. So everybody come down, bring your knees down. So this plank also, many people are not doing it right. So just observe me. Come to the tabletop position, please, everybody. So how you do it? You're in a tabletop position. Bring your one leg back, your other leg back. So see, the whole body is in one straight line. Yes, very good. Like some people were doing like this, some people were doing like this. This is not good. So it should be like this. The whole body is like a wooden plank, straight. Now bring your knees down, chest down. Ashtang Namaskar. Slide your body forward and come to the cobra. Tuck your feet in, come to downward facing dog. Stay here. I'll just check the alignment of everybody. So push your chest a little bit more towards the thighs. You can move your legs a little forward, one foot forward, not the hands, not the legs. Push your chest towards the thighs. Pull your navel in. Yes, Vinita, very nice. And it's okay if your knees are a little bit bent, your heels are not touching the floor. Kartik, you can push your upper chest towards the thigh a little bit. Yeah, open the fingers in your palms. Press your hands onto the floor actively. Now let's bring your left leg forward. Remember the alignment. If it is not, then adjust your leg position. Drop your right leg down and look up. So now you remember, you know the alignment, so you have to be mindful to correct it. Bring your right leg forward, forward bend. Breathing in, bring your hands up to the back bend. And breathing out, relax your hands. So it's very important to do the with the correct alignment. Otherwise, you will just learn the wrong and then you will keep doing it. And it becomes hard later to correct it, to unlearn it. Okay? Okay, let's bring our hands in the front, palms facing each other. This is very good asana for reducing your obliques, for your digestion. Now, imagine you're holding a block or something in your hand so that your distance in the palm is staying the same, whatever we do, okay? Pull your navel in, breathe out. Bring your hands towards the right side. Twist your body towards the right side, upper body. Your hands are parallel to each other, same distance. Now see if you can twist from your waist a little bit and look over your right shoulder. Your right foot tend to turn, but don't let it turn. Press it back to the floor. Keep breathing. Gently bring your hands to the center. Come to front. Your hands are very straight. It's not like this loose, okay? Your hands are working. Breathe in, breathing out. Turn your body towards the left side. It's called Kati Chakrasana. Keep twisting from your waist now. Make sure your left foot is on the ground, firmly pressing the floor. And look over your left shoulder. Breathing in, bring your hands forward. And relax your hands. I'll explain the back bend also. Chakrasana, Ardha Chakrasana, because we do that in our sun salutation and the forward fold. So just listen one time. Bring your hand behind the back, lower back, and push your hips forward. You can keep your chin to the chest right now. And when you feel you cannot go any more forward, then you drop your head back. So this is kind of a back bend, and you're supporting the lower back with your hands. Okay? Let's do everybody. Take a deep breath in. Bring your hands to your lower back. And push your hips forward. In the beginning, you can bring your chin to the chest. Keep pushing your hips forward. And then when you feel you cannot bend anymore, drop your head behind. Look back. Push your feet into the ground for the stability. People who have any back issues, please don't do too much deeper. And when you come out, Vrinda, come out very, very slowly and gently. Okay? All right. I'll explain, I think I explained before, but let me explain the forward fold also. Bring your hands up, push your hips back. It's the opposite of the back bend. And look forward, bring your hands forward. Just stay here in the beginning and see, imagine you're pushing a ball in the front. Pull your navel in. And now, after that, gently drop your hands wherever they go. It cannot touch the floor, that's fine. Okay, don't go like this when you are around your back. If you want to go further, pull your navel in. Keep bending from your hips, and then you go. So for these people who cannot touch the floor, they can use the block, and they can rest here, hands on the block. Okay. I will watch. Let's try everybody. Come to the standing position. Bring your hands up. Push your hips back. That is the key here. Push your hips back. Pull your navel in. Come only till center. Torso parallel to the floor. And now if you cannot bend anymore, drop your hands wherever it goes. On your calves, on your legs. Wherever, don't try, Karthik, don't try to touch the floor. Come to your calves. Yes. All right. So this one also we do a lot. So just remember, slowly come up, okay? Slowly. All right. So now let's do some standing asana, warrior one and two, okay? And I will explain the alignment as we are going. Bend your knees and jump to around 3 feet distance. Your legs are 3 feet distance. Karthik, you want to change the orientation of your mat? Are you okay? So in this, the toes are pointing forward because our knees are pointing forward. So toes are always in the direction of our knees. Okay. Now, turn your right foot 90 degrees. Make sure when you're turning your right foot, your hip is not turning, okay? Only the foot is turning, your hips are facing forward, and your left foot is 10 to 15 degrees inside. Now bring your hands parallel to the floor. So we'll do right now pushing the wall posture because that is needed for all the postures. Bring your left hand onto your left hip, and slide your body forward like you're pushing a ball. Keep your fingers like you're pushing a ball. Keep pushing, keep sliding your body towards the right side as much as you can. Both of the legs are straight. Now drop your right hand towards the right leg, wherever it goes, and bring your left hand up. So it's a Trikona Asana, triangle pose. And you're looking forward right now, and your shoulder is little back. You're not bending forward or backward. And if your neck allows, turn at your left palm. Keep breathing. And gently making your right hand strong, come up. So this was the triangle pose. Now from here, we'll go to warrior two. Keep your palms facing up. Now just gently bend your right knee. Again, do not slide your body like this. Okay, just bend your right knee. See if you can increase the distance between your legs. And again, the right knee is perpendicular to your ankle, not going inwards or outward. And look at your right palm. And smile. Your hands are very, very stable. It's not like this loose, okay? Every part of your body is working. It's a very good asana for your legs, strengthening your legs. Back leg pushing into the floor. Now slide your body a little bit towards the right side and bring all the hands back. Right hand above the ear, left hand behind the back. And look over your right palm. Reverse warrior. Breathing in, bring your right hand onto your right thigh and left hand above the ear. Side angle triangle and look over the left palm. Now people who have little bit more flexibility, if you want to try, they can bring their right hand towards the floor and left hand straight up. If you don't have it, don't push your body. I just give options for the people who have been doing practice a little bit longer. And then gently come up. Bring your hands up. Now straighten your right leg. Turn your body towards the right. Bring your hands to the hips. And bring your left foot a little bit on the left side in a 45 degree angle. Okay? We'll do warrior one. Bring your hands up. Now bend your right knee forward. Do not slide your body forward, just bend the right knee. And look to your palms. Warrior one. Push your back leg to the floor, straighten your knee. Just the right knee is lunging. Now relax your palms. Straighten your right leg. We'll do another posture. Shorten the distance between your legs a little bit. Bring the back leg a little closer. Breathe in. Bring your hands up. So right leg is straight. Both of the legs are straight. Pull your navel in. Bend forward. Bring your hands to your legs or the mat, wherever it comes. And drop your head to the knee. See if you can touch your knee. If you cannot, that's perfectly fine. Don't push your body. Just a little effort and then let go. Little effort is required, but after that, you just let go and enjoy wherever you are. Breathing in, bring your hands up. Breathing out, relax your hands. Now let's turn your body forward, both of the toes pointing forward. We'll do the wide-legged forward fold. So breathe in, breathing out, push your hips back. Whenever we do forward fold, standing forward, we push our hips back and pull our navel in. Look forward. Bring your upper body parallel to the floor. Keep looking forward. If you need to increase the distance between your feet, you can do so. And when you cannot bend anymore, drop your hands to the mat. If it does not touch the mat, bring it to your leg. Hold your leg. This is also another good option to use the block if your hands do not touch the floor. We People who have a little bit more flexibility, they can bend their elbows and bring their head to the floor. Very good posture for your inner thighs. Keep breathing and gently come onto your palms. Shorten the distance between your legs. Bring your hands to your hips. Slowly and gently, mindful of your back, come up. Now we'll do everything on the other side. Turn your left foot 90 degrees, right foot 10 to 15 degrees. Your hips are facing forward. Bring your hands up. Now, imagine there is a wall on the left side and you're pushing the wall. Bring your right hand on your hips and slide your left hand towards the left side. You can look at the left side. And when you cannot push anymore, drop this hand towards the left leg, wherever it goes, and bring your right hand up towards the ceiling. Look at your right palm. Triangle pose. It's very good for your neck also, as long as your neck is not hurting in this direction. Now bring your hands up, come to the standing position. We'll do warrior two, your palms are facing up. Now just bend your left knee. If you need to, you can move your back leg a little back so that your body is not sliding, and look at your left palm. Make sure your knee is not crossing your toe, okay? Slide your body towards the left side and then bring your left hand up and right hand behind the back. Look over your left palm. Bring your left hand onto your thigh, right hand above the right ear. Side angle triangle. Vinita, bring your shoulder little back. Don't bend forward. Bring your upper body little back. And if you want, you can slide your left hand towards the floor and right hand behind the back. And look up. Side angle triangle. Extended side angle triangle. Gently come up. Turn your, relax your legs, straighten your legs. Shorten the distance in between your legs a little bit. Turn your body towards the left side. So now the both of the hips are facing to the left. Breathing in, bring your hands up. Join your palms together. Breathing out, bend your left knee and look up to your palms. If you cannot hold your elbow straight, you can collapse your fingers and pull your hands up. Breathing in, come up. Straighten your left leg. And now we'll do the bend forward in this. Bring your right leg little bit forward towards the left leg. This is called a pyramid pose. Bring your hands up. Breathe in, breathing out. Look forward. Bend forward. And bring your hands to your leg or the mat. See if you can bring your forehead to the knee. Both of the legs are straight in this. Breathing in, gently come up. Bring your hands up. Relax your hands. And face forward. We'll do one more type of wide-legged forward fold. This time bring your hands back. Clasp your fingers together. And pull your shoulders back. Breathe in, breathing out, push your hips back, bend forward, pull your navel in, and bring your hands towards the ceiling. Bring your head towards the floor. Stretch your hands towards the ceiling. Keep breathing. And gently and slowly bring your head down, bring your upper body up, shorten the distance between your feet, and come to the standing position. Breathing in, bring your hands up, bend your knees a little bit, and sit in a chair. Push your hips back. Sit down, and sit down. Let's come on to our belly. So today we spent a lot of time on the standing asanas, on the alignment, on the correction. So just practice a little bit whatever you remember, maybe in the evening. Hands on your side, palms facing up. Stretch your right leg outward. And lift your right foot away from the floor, about 6 to 8 inches. Half locust pose, Ardha Shalabhasana. You can raise it higher, but remember, keep stretching it outwards as well. Main goal is to stretch your leg outward, not to go too high if it is not possible. And relax your right leg. Let's do the other side. Stretch your left leg outward and lift it up away from the floor. Keep stretching it outward and lifting up as much as you can. Tighten your glutes and relax your left leg. Make a fist of both of your hands. Put it under your groin area. Push your elbows down. Stretch both of the feet outward and lift both of the legs up. Push your elbows down and tighten your glutes. And you can lift your legs a little bit more up. Poon Shalabhasana, full locust pose. And gently bring your legs down. Now let's bring our palms. So I'm going to explain how to do cobra. Bring your palms next to your shoulders. Palms facing down. Elbows hugging your body. Breathe in, bring your head up, chest up, look forward, shoulders back and relaxed, away from the ear. Your navel is touching the floor. Tighten your glutes. Breathing out, bring your head down, relax your head on the floor. Let's do Superman. Bring your hands forward. So the Superman is kind of combining your cobra and your locust pose. Bring your hands up, your legs up, thighs up, chest up. You're resting on your navel. You can bring your hands behind the back, clasp your fingers, and pull your hands back. And see if you can raise your chest and hips a little bit higher. Keep breathing here. Imagine you're a Spider-Man. You're going over different buildings. You can rock your body left and right. And gently drop your body down. Palms facing up. Now we'll do Dhanurasana. Let's start bending our knees and kick your buttocks with your heels. Now hold your ankle with your hands. Hold it tight. Breathe in. Bring your head up, chest up, thighs up, knees up. Push your legs into your hands. Keep breathing. And gently come down. Relax your legs. Relax your hands. make a pillow of your hands, rest your forehead onto the hands and bend your left leg. Come to the crocodile. Take a deep breath in and we'll exhale a humming sound. Another breath in. One more time. Relax your hands and come onto your back. Now bend your right knee. Hold it, hold the knee with the hands and push the knee towards the chest. Left leg is straight, completely on the floor. Breathe in, breathing out, bring your head up. See if you can touch your knee. Your nose can touch your knee. Pavan Muktasana. Very, very good pose for digestion. Breathing in, bring your head back. With the support of the left hand, turn your knee towards the left side. Open your right palm and look at your right palm. Natarajasana. Another good pose for digestion, for your whole spine, for diabetes, increasing your metabolism. Breathing in, bring your leg to the center, relax your right leg. Let's do on the other side. Bend your left leg, hold it with the hands, push the knee towards the chest. Keep your right leg touching the floor. Breathe in, breathing out, bring your head up. See if you can touch your nose to the knee. Pull your navel in. Gently bring your head down, holding the right leg, left leg with the right hand. Twist towards your right side. And look at your left palm. Natarajasana, supine twist. Always in the end of your practice, where you do use lot of back, always end up with this posture because it is neutralizing your whole back, the whole spine. Bring your leg back. Now bend both of the knees together. Hold it with the hands. Squeeze your knees towards the chest. Bring your head up. See if you can bring your nose in between of the knees. Squeeze it a little bit more. Make yourself a very small compact ball. And bring your head down now. Let's rock our body left and right. Massage your whole spine. Rock your body forward and backward. And come to the center one more time. Hold the knees with both of the hands. Push it against the chest. Breathe in, breathing out, bring your head up. See if you can bring your nose in between of the knees. Squeeze yourself as much as you can. A very small ball. Now when we come out of this posture, we will breathe out with the open mouth and relax every part of our body on the floor. Take a deep breath in and breathe out. Relax your legs, relax your hands. Let your whole body rest on Mother Earth. Your hands are away from your body, palms facing up. Fingers are naturally curled. Your legs are a little bit apart. Feet are rolling on either side of your leg. Relax your whole body. Let go of any efforts. Take a deep breath in. Expand your belly. Fill it up like you are filling air in a balloon. Little bit more. Little more than what you get. Feel your lower back is lifting away from the floor. Breathe out. Pull your navel in. Sink all the way to the floor. Feel lower back fully rested on the floor. People who have lower back issue, they can do this couple of times in the day. Even when you sleep, it will really help. One more time, take a deep breath in. Expand your belly. Little bit more than last time. And gently breathe out. Pull your navel in. Rest your lower back. Take a deep breath in and let go. Relax each and every muscle of your body. Let go any tightness. Let go any efforts. It's time to relax now. Relax your toes, calf muscles, knees. Relax your thighs, inner thighs, outer thighs. Relax your hips. Relax both of the legs completely. Relax your lower abdomen, stomach region, chest. Relax your palms, wrist, shoulders, shoulder blades. Relax your throat, back of the neck. Add a smile on your face. Relax your facial muscles. Your cheeks, eyeballs, forehead, top of the head. Relax your whole body, whole body. Gently wiggle your toes, wiggle your fingers, bring your hands, top of your head, clasp your fingers and take a full body stretch. Turn your body towards your right side. Taking the support of your hand, gently sit up in any sitting position, keeping your eyes closed. Take few deep breaths in and out. You can do alternate nostril breathing. Does everybody know how to do alternate nostril breathing? If not, just bring your right thumb onto the right nostril, index finger and middle finger in between of the eyebrows, other two fingers on the left nostril. Take a breath in. Close your right nostril and breathe out from left. Breathe in from left. Close the left and breathe out from right. Breathe in from right. Close the right and breathe out from left. And continue. Long, deep breath in and out.